Hey guys, just another gamer here, and this video is going to be like slightly or like very late because I gotta compile some stuff in together with this and I was like out for the whole day. So but in any other case, we will still be going through on like the exclusive summons, and then we do on some summons on my own, then we'll see what we get and like some, because this week's like some decision making. Okay, but I will like go through that like after we actually review them on like these 4 weeks of like the summons, including this week. So for this week, what we do have is like area, which is like, okay, I would say that this Archangel is like purely on like the healing base, and then what I see in the world is like people were like ruining it with Nemesis, so that it can be like a little bit more irritating with like his crazy Archangel's blessings heal and then the holy water. So sometimes if you do not have enough firepower, this area might be like a little bit problem with you. And then nowadays it's like not many units are using that Nemesis, so naturally people will like put this like an okay piece of like the will or like violent on then Nemesis. So Nemesis should be like quite a super rune, because I do have the a set of Nemesis which is on like my Sigmarers, because the subs are just that pretty good. It has like I think a total of like 37 speed subs from that two runes, and then it had like I think over 25% critical rate. Then it's a one of that is like an attack percent rune, and another has like 9% attack percent. Yep. So I mean, if you actually farm enough, you will know that you will actually get tons of that. So next up we have is like a Perna. So Perna wise, I feel that, I mean, it's still like a legit material, although that people will be like going on and on with like Xyros, your Perna and such. So definitely this guy will be like on the wheel and violent. And then I would say that this kit, I've seen like units or like people using this as like a solo healer in like guild battles, because each turn that Perna gets, he actually recovers all allies by 10%. So all allies excluding itself, and then it will like, it will also revive itself in like after, I mean, with a full HP bar, and then when this is max is like 8 turns cooldown, then for this second skill it's like 2 turns. So I like the same all the Phoenix, their second skill, because they can actually like they are like only 2 turns cooldown. So if a Perna is like is on like a defense, it will like keep doing this skill, Flame Nova, then it will go for this Arcane Blast, which can stun you, and then it will go for another Flame Nova again. Then this can actually kill anybody, probably like using 2 of these skills, I guess. That's what I do see around. Then next up we have is Edna. So a guilty of mine just put this, so I mean let's just look through what it has. So for the first skill it has is the Sharp Blade. Okay, they'll just inflict continuous damage for 2 turns. I don't think anybody will do like revenge on this. Then Shatter, which is a 2 turns defense break, and if I'm not wrong, this is like 2 turns cooldown when it's max. And then Capture, which is like, if I'm not wrong, also it's like 3 turns cooldown, so it's like a 1-2-3. So I think back then a friend of mine did like a super speedy one which just keeps doing on like Shatter and then Capture. It has like additional of like 120 over speed. So I feel that if I were to get Anna, I mean that would be something that I might try it out. But of course the key here is that, because I've been like looking through like the summons on like all the net 4s and net 5s for the next few weeks, the key that I might need could be like Galleon in order to open the door for like using those units. Because another friend of mine, okay, a guildie of mine, quite a close guildie, so he has like the Punk Big, but then we are, both of us are like short of Galleon. I'm not sure if he actually summoned, but okay, I think I'll probably like open the door for me to use a Galleon. Then I'll just think of like what I'm going to use with Galleon right after that. Then apart from that, we have is the Emma, which I've been saying that this Q when it's max is like 4 turns cooldown. So if you actually pair this thing with like one of your like defense or like the armor based kind of units which deals damage, like the Frankensteins or like the Copper, I feel that you might actually lack 2 turns of your this defense bar, because, or maybe just on MR, because you can have like super speed, so that like 2 times the speed of your Copper, so that when she moves 4 times and then she can actually refresh the Copper's defense buff, so that Copper should have the permanent, but MR herself, I do not know. So I'm just a little bit skeptical and worried about having that without that 2 turns of that buff on like MR herself. So apart from that, she has cutting magic, which is the same as Lisa, and Lisa, which will be the one, the fire one, which does on the attack command. So this skill can actually remove on like, if we actually, if it actually removes two or more beneficial effects, then the attack bar will be like increased by 20% each. So I think it's like something like an anti-Chloe, and then you just like go in and whack like just that one person, maybe like a Chasun, because if you actually take down a healer, more or less your battle should be won unless violent procs occur. Then the rest of them, I feel that the leech, I think if I were to build a leech, I'll build like the water or the wind, which is for Necropolis, then practically that's much. Then for the Kung Fu girl, we just go straight for using on the, what's that, the dark one, which is Fae. Then last but not least for this week, we have is the wind sylph. So the wind sylph wise, I guess you can use this for like arena lead, and then this skill, when it's awakened, it will become 3 hits. The rest of them, okay, this third skill, basically it just slow an opponent and then speed buff on yourself. So that's just all for it. As for the net trees, nothing that much notable. Okay, then we'll move on to like next week. So next week we have is Camilla, Fire Monkey King, and Leo. So all these are like, okay, I would say that most of these are like for AO, of course. And then as for ADs, I think it'll be like Camilla, or and more preferably it would be like Camilla for like your defense. I mean, I will like touch more into them like next week or in such. I'll just like cover more towards the coming week to give you guys like maybe like a brief idea on like what I should pull or what shouldn't I pull. Then as for the rest of them, the net force or this, I mean for next week, I feel that only Lushen could be like something which can be useful. I use Lushen for like my leader skill, and then other than that, Lushen would be like for my giants as a leader skill also. I mean practically I think it's just for giants, or else it'd be like for the elemental horse. So nothing else about it. Then for next two weeks later, we have his Poseidon. It can be very good for like Necropolis. Drangus, I mean, sorry about that. Then because of this minus of the 75% bar, and then you're slowing down on like the two towers, because I'm like trying out Mantua for like my Drangus B10. The timing is pretty good, but if like one of my attackers is down, which is like Tumas or Sigmarus, I might not be able to complete on like the battle. So practically that's much about the having a slow. So in addition, in like, because Maelstrom also reduces on the attack bar by 75%, and then I guess this could be like around 5 turns cooldown, or maybe, I don't think it'd be like 4 turns, because 4 turns would be like too overpowered. So I guess it'd be like around 5 turns, and then you have the attack power by yourself. So this unit, I feel that it has quite a great potential in it. And for the second skill, which prevents on like the opponents from using skills, it could be also something. So okay, I drifted out a little bit, so I'm getting back. I'll just focus more on like the rough idea about the units. So Occult Girl for Rika, I feel that she actually changed from like the attacker, because the guaranteed critical hits back then, right now it's like continuous damage. So it could be like landing on like 3 dots over the units, which I know what you guys might be thinking, this could be more for like the Child of Ascension, other than losing like a Zyros. So because this guy has like a stun, so that could be like another alternative which I can think of. Last but not least, we have is Sierra for in 2 weeks time, which is pretty good on like AO and also AD, but you just have to write comp with it. So and then it comes with a 24% speed lead, so that's a very good unit. Then other than that, 2 weeks time we have is Avert. I guess most of you guys will be like going for it. I still do not have like much idea of like if I actually want Avert, because I mean I'll tell you guys why I do not really want. At first I don't already want to go for a Galleon, but after much thoughts, I think I might just do a Galleon. Then the rest of the net force, not pretty much, but I have Sue Man. But if you do not have Tailmask, I think that Sue could be like a good alternative towards that, because at the same time she also gains like 15% critical rate upon awakening. So once you get Tailmask, you can just throw all the runes from Sue to Tailmask. That's like my idea on it. Then for the net trees, I think Kelp is alright, then Kali is alright, and Frankenstein, the bulldozer, is alright. The earlier weeks, nothing are like that really useful to me. And then in 3 weeks time, we have Isbastet, Kumar and Elejo. So what I feel that they are more like supports. Unless you have like good violent and wheel set, then Kumar will be actually a very good nuker in like your AD or even for like your AO, because for mine is more like a support. I'll probably do more videos about it like in a few days time. Then apart from them, Elijah will be like the healer, and then Bastet could be like for Trial of Ascension, or else it would be like for raids. So I guess I particularly kept or like gone through like most of this. So alright then, I will pause the video for a little bit while, and then we'll like continue right after that. I will like insert one of the summons which I did somewhere earlier last week. Yep, so I'll be right back. See you guys in a bit.
Hey guys, so right now I'm going to pop on like the TOA or the scroll. So what I have is like 2 legendaries, then 3 light and darkness, and then I managed to fetch up like this light and darkness pieces to get to 50. So, okay, I mean, let's just do it and then we'll see what we get. Wonder what this gonna be like. Wait, am I like DC or something? Let me like get the connection to a better spot. Okay, so okay, finally pop out. So is this like Mystic Witch? So for this, I don't think that the only thing that it works is like when it's like in the TOA, then probably things will actually work out much better. Not this guy, of course. Not something that I want. Then let's just go for the pieces. Let's just see if like what we can get. Oh, Shren. Okay. I've actually like saving up the high elementals for this, but there's only a lack of the attack buff, or else this would be like quite usable, because I use like the Kali and Katarina in like most of my this battle. So alright, so this will be the last lightning darkness. So didn't get any lightning from this. Okay, this is crap. Neil is the light fairy. Then okay, we just pop on like the legendary scrolls, then whatever happens just happens. Other than that, it'll be okay. So the Wind Leech, and then wait, don't they come up with the essence package or something? Nope. So that'll be an Orion. Yep, so that's all for what we have for this summons. Then yep, I'll stop right here. Alright, so as I was saying earlier, whereby I'm like thinking not to go for Galleon, and I'm also thinking for going for Galleon, because I'm actually like more interested towards next week's on like the net 5s, especially like Camilla, which I believe most of you guys should know that I'm actually aiming for that. Then alternatively, I'm actually aiming for like a Pearl Knight if I can get, because I mean, face it, everybody wants these two units. Then for like 2 weeks time, actually all of them are also pretty alright, but for 3 weeks time, I have Huma, but the rest of them I'm not too sure. But by then I believe that in 2 weeks time, by the end of that, I should have like exhaust all of my stones, or maybe I might change like my decisions in like summoning for the units. So yep, I think this week what I do have, I'll be like going for like hoping for a Galleon, but I'm also hoping to like get some units for the next weeks. So what I think is that I will like set a small little threshold in like my summons, which could be like approximately, I'll probably save like around 800 or like 700 remaining. Then next week I will throw in like some of the stones for like either of the net 4s or net 5s, which is like Lushen, or else would be like Camilla, Leo, or like either of the net 5s. I think all of them can actually work. But then again, I actually reverse back my decisions, because if I get, I mean, I've been summoning for like quite a while since my last net 5, and I'm like exhausting all my mystical scrolls every other week. So what I'm actually thinking is that if I get any 3 of them, it could work pretty much and more practically well if I get like a Galleon. So that could be like my window to actually opening up using Galleon somehow or somewhere. So okay, let's not talk so much about it. So
Yep, I guess I'll like try for like some exclusive summons, then we'll see what we can get. Then hopefully hope I have I okay, the threshold that I have set is like I was saving like 800 to 900, or else it could be like around 3 lightnings and then I'll just stop. Or else if I get a Galleon, then we'll see when I get the Galleon, then we'll just stop. So no funny tricks or anything, but I'll just stop talking and then we'll just summon. Because I'm like also quite excited on like what I can actually get from like these weeks. So first of all we have is the Wind Drunken Master. So for like those units that I do not talk about, we'll like, I mean, it's like not so that really good. So for this, I think it's like a fusion monster, is it? Yep, fusion monster is one. Then alternatively, we can actually use this for like Jotun and Asher skill ups. Okay, then Adrilla, which is the Wind Magical Archer. I think the light and dark one are like much better. And the reason being is that it's a net 4, of course. Okay, Water Serpent, which can be used for like the Water Horrors fusion. So, is it good or is it bad? I do not really know much about it. So, okay, so Fire Inferno. So this is like the, I think 6. Okay, so the Wind Amazon. Or Amazon. Whatever, how you guys call it. Then another Fire Werewolf. Okay, Fire Marshal Cat, something new. I mean, I haven't got that for today, but now that I have gotten it, not too much of it, like I would say of it, because I don't think it's like even worth it to even build that. Neither is building this Inferno because it's way too squishy in my opinion. So I mean, what I do like is that I'll just have like more of like the net force instead of like the others. Okay, so the first one that I got from Lightning, that would be the Kung Fu Girl. So we have like 1470 stones. Oh, Arena. Okay, not that I need. If I'm left with like 800 stones, I think like 800 or 700 stones, I think that's it for like this week's summon. And probably I'll like just throw into like Mystical Scrolls. Probably. We'll see how this goes. Another winner. And you guys do know that this week it will be the free rune removal. So, gotta plan properly for like your units. Okay. Hope this could be like a Galleon. Another Kung Fu Girl. How do you like farm extra for like for what I won the other time? Because of the Hall of Heroes. And of course, haven't got any lightning from like the light and dark. Oh crap. this like the awakened one of that Wind Amazon. Okay, a Fire Werewolf again, of course. Okay, I think we just hope like for like one last lightning and something, then we'll like just stop. This like 1000 stones already. Okay, another Rina. Okay, I think like two more summons and then like I think that that's practically much of like what I'm going to summon on for today. Or should I like, go for like until the end? I mean, I just hope to get like one more lightning and then we can like just see
what's going to be like. Okay, another cat. So I think Galleon's like over for like today's case. I have like 13 more. Okay, maybe I just like go for like another one or two more, then let's see how it goes. Let's skip this, then we'll go for last one. Okay, so I think that's all for like today, I guess. I have like another 10 more scores or something, but I think that I can actually... Do I really want to like go for like even more? If I go for like 10 more, there will be like another... I'll be left with like 120 then. Let's have a look. Cause I still might be like aiming for like a Lushen or something, but I think we'll just stop at like another lightning. Let's just see. Could it be like regrets? Okay, maybe we'll stop like 300. Okay, maybe we can like finish it all. Last scroll. Okay, this is like crap. Totally nothing or like Galleon or anything. Yep, I guess probably that's all for today. Then we'll see how it goes for like the upcoming weeks. Yep, so see you guys soon. Thanks for watching and then goodbye.